Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss about amlodipine, how this drug acts, what is the mechanism, side effects, drug interactions and precautions of amlodipine. What is this amlodipine? Amlodipine is one of the calcium channel blocker, which is commonly known as CCB. But this drug can be differentiated from the other calcium channel blockers with few structural features. We can split the name into three parts. The prefix AM indicates this drug is having some amino group attached with ethoxy. So amino ethoxy group is present in the amlodipine. And the infix low indicates this drug is having a chloro group, because we have the groups like chlorine and nitro group can influence the potency of the drug. So this drug is having a chloro group in the structure. And finally, the suffix dipine indicates this drug is a dihydropyridine. So from the dihydropyridine, we can take the suffix dipine. This is the structure of dihydropyridine, which is having the saturation at first and fourth positions. So amlodipine is a dihydropyridine with amino ethoxy moiety and chloro group within the structure. Now if we see the chemical nature of amlodipine, this is the structure of amlodipine. And here we can find the heterocyclic ring system, that is the pyridine. So let us give the numbering from the nitrogen. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now this ring is saturated at first and fourth position. So commonly it is known as 1,4 dihydropyridine. And we can also find the ester groups at third and fifth position. So the suffix of the name is nothing but pyridine 3,5 dicarboxylate. It's a diester. But here the esters are not formed by the same groups. At the third position, ethyl group is forming the ester, but at the fifth position, methyl group is forming the ester. So we can put the prefix 3-thyl-5-methyl. Then what are the other attachments? So second position is simply attached with a methyl group, which is further attached with a different group. So already we have seen it is having amino ethoxy group. So at the second position, this methyl group is further attached with the amino ethoxy group. So we can write this as 2-2-aminoethoxymethyl. Then what is the group at the fourth position? Fourth position is having a phenyl ring, which is attached with a chloro group at the ortho position. So we can write this as 4-2-chlorophenyl. And this pyridine ring system is saturated at first and fourth position. So 1,4-dihydro. And sixth position, it is having the methyl group. So 6-methyl. So that completes the name of the amlodipine. Now let us see how amlodipine name is derived from the chemical name. So from this amino ethoxy, we are going to take the AM. And from this chloro, we are going to take the LO. And from this dihydro, we are going to take DI. And from the pyridine, we are going to take the P and I and E. So that is the amlodipine. So amlodipine is a calcium channel blocker, which is having an amino ethoxy group and chlorine group, along with a dihydropyridine ring system. Now let us see how this drug acts. Amlodipine is one of the calcium channel blocker. It can block the L-type calcium channels present on the cardiac muscle, as well as it can also block the L-type calcium channels present on the vascular smooth muscle. And particularly, dihydropyridines are more selective towards the vascular smooth muscle. So amlodipine shows the more affinity towards the L-type calcium channels present on the vascular smooth muscle compared with the cardiac muscle. But still, this drug can show action on both cardiac muscle as well as vascular smooth muscle. Now let us see action on cardiac muscle. Within the cardiac muscle, different types of ion channels are present. One of the important ion channels are the sodium channels. So through these voltage-gated sodium channels, sodium can enter into the membrane, which produces the depolarization of the cardiac muscle. So when the sodium ions are entered, the action potential is going to be propagated into the T-tubules. And when this action potential reaches to the T-tubules, calcium channels are going to be activated. So these calcium channels are the L-type calcium channels. And calcium within the cardiac muscle is also controlled by the store-operated calcium channels, which are present on the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now, when the action potential reaches to the T-tubules, the calcium ions can enter through these L-type calcium channels, and then they can activate the store-operated calcium channels. These store-operated calcium channels are nothing but the rhinodine receptors, which when they are activated, they can release a large amount of the calcium into the cytoplasm. In this way, when the L-type calcium channels are activated, it results in the increased intracellular calcium levels within the cardiac muscle, which result in the contraction of the cardiac muscle. So this is the normal contractile mechanism within the cardiac muscle. Now the amlodipine, which is administered, can be protonated within the plasma. So within this protonated form, it can act on the L-type calcium channels. Amlodipine can bind to one of the binding sites. This is called as dihydropyridine binding site. Now this drug is going to bind to this dihydropyridine binding site such that it is going to inhibit the L-type calcium channel activity. So when these calcium channels are inactivated, calcium cannot enter and it cannot produce the contraction of the cardiac muscle. In this way, amlodipine can reduce the rate of contraction as well as force of contraction of the heart. Now let us see the action of the amlodipine on vascular smooth muscle. So vascular smooth muscle is again equipped with the L-type calcium channels. Now calcium can enter through these L-type calcium channels into the cytoplasm. But here the contractile mechanism is somewhat different. This calcium can bind with the calmodulin. So calcium can bind with this calmodulin so that it forms a calcium calmodulin complex. This will activate the myosin light chain kinases. These myosin light chain kinases are going to be activated by this calcium calmodulin complex. And this MLCK is required for phosphorylation of the MLC, myosin light chains. Now, MLC are the myosin light chains which are phosphorylated by MLCK, says that MLC is coming to MLC phosphate, the phosphorylated form of the myosin light chains. Within this phosphorylated form, they can combine with the actin filament, says that they are going to form an actomyosin complex. When this actin and myosin are going to form an actomyosin complex, it results in the sliding on each other, producing the contraction of the vascular smooth muscle. In this way, L-type calcium channels are playing an important role in contraction of the vascular smooth muscle. Now again, these L-type calcium channels are having dihydropyridine binding site on which the amlodipine can bind. Amlodipine is going to interact with this dihydropyridine binding site such that it is going to inhibit the activity of the L-type calcium channels. So just like the cardiac muscle, amlodipine again inhibits the L-type calcium channel activity, thereby it inhibits the contraction of the vascular smooth muscle. So these are the two important mechanisms of the amlodipine. It can block the L-type calcium channel such that it can inhibit the contraction of the cardiac muscle as well as the vascular smooth muscle. What are the side effects? The important side effect is the headache as well as edema. These two side effects are mainly related with the vasodilatation as well as increased capillary permeability. So these two side effects are more important in many of the patients. The headache is because of cerebral vasodilatation and edema is because of the accumulation of the body fluids. Apart from these two side effects, amlodipine can also produce few of the other side effects like fatigue, nausea, abdominal pain, and it can also produce a somnolence, and few of the vasodilatory symptoms like dizziness, flushing can also be observed. Amlodipine can also produce a palpitations because of the reflex mechanism. What are the precautions? Already we have seen that amlodipine can act on the cardiac muscle such that it reduces the force of contraction. When the force of contraction is going to be reduced, it reduces the cardiac output. So this is somewhat important in the patients who are having the cardiovascular disorders. So amlodipine can aggravate the angional attack as well as the myocardial infarction. Particularly these conditions are elevated in the patients who are having an obstruction in the cardiac conduction system. So amlodipine should be carefully given in the patients who are having the angina and myocardial infarction along with the obstruction in the cardiac conduction system. Second precaution is amlodipine is converted to metabolites within the liver. This drug is long acting with half-life of 56 hours. But in the patients who are having the severe hepatic failure, this metabolism may be impaired, which may result in the increased half-life of amlodipine. So in such patients, there may be an accumulation of the amlodipine levels within the plasma, which should be carefully monitored. Third important precaution is amlodipine is going to produce a vasodilatation, thereby it produces the hypotension. Even it is not producing the acute hypotension, but still any symptoms of hypotension like flushing, dizziness, and headache should be carefully monitored in the drug interactions. So already we have seen amlodipine is metabolized within the liver into the metabolites, and one of the important enzymes is the CYP3A4. So few of the drugs like ketoconazole, itraconazole, and ritonavir, these are the strong CYP3A4 inhibitors which can inhibit the metabolism of the amlodipine, resulting in the increased levels of this drug. So whenever strong CYP3A4 inhibitor, the plasma level should be carefully monitored. Clinical uses. Since this drug is a vasodilator, it is particularly used in the treatment of hypertension. It can be given alone or in combination in the treatment of hypertension. Similarly, this drug can also act on the heart and it can also reduce the afterload. So this drug is useful in the treatment of vasospastic angina as well as chronic stable angina. And sometimes amlodipine can also be given in the coronary artery disease in the patients who are not associated with the heart failure. Because in the heart failure, cardiac output is already reduced. Amlodipine is reducing the force of contraction, which further reduces the cardiac output. So in the patients who are having heart failure, particularly in the patients who are having the less ejection fraction, in such people, amlodipine should not be used. How it is given? Amlodipine is available as a tablet in the different doses like 2.5 mg, 5 mg and 10 mg. The initial dose is started at 5 mg per day and the maximum dose that can be administered is 10 mg. But in the patients who are having severe hepatic impairment, the dose may be reduced. So initial dose may be reduced to 2.5 mg. So that's about the amlodipine. Amlodipine is a calcium channel blocker with an amino ethoxy group as well as chloro group within the structure. This drug can act on both cardiac muscle as well as vascular smooth muscle with more affinity towards the vascular smooth muscle. And since this drug acts as a vasodilator, this drug can be used in the treatment of hypertension as well as vasospastic and chronic stable angina. And this drug can also be given if you have the coronary artery disease in the patients who are not associated with the heart failure. This drug is protonated within the plasma and it can block the L-type calcium channels by binding to the dihydropyridine binding site. Headache and edema are the two important side effects that can be produced by this amlodipine. So that's about this drug. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.